Okay guys, now we're ready to do some painting on Godzilla here. I had done some painting on the egg, and I picked out a light blue that I'm going to add the pattern on here, and then I'll have some white dots. I did a little bit more work on the base. Pretty much just dry brushed a little bit and dry brushed the top with a lighter tan. I don't want it to stand out a whole lot. That's kind of how I liked it to be. So when you get ready to paint your model and you're pretty much you think you're done with the putty and seam work, they gave me a picture here, but I don't really like how blue it looks in this picture. To decide on colors, you can get a Godzilla book or look online at different things. But today I made kind of a gray color that I thought was good. It's a little bit on the brownish side, and I'm gonna start applying it on here. Thing about painting is you can always repaint if you don't like what you did. But I kind of want this Godzilla to have a bit of a brownish look to him. If you ever look at pictures of the 64 Godzilla, you'll see like on the brows they're kind of brown looking, and so if I'm going to do that, I think it's better to go that direction with a little bit on the tannish brown side. So I mix this color up, and I'm applying it on top of the gray primer now and covering up where I had done the putty work. And that helps me see if I want to do more putty work or if it needs any help. I'm going to brush this in pretty good into the texture of the model. And to me, the big thing about painting is I like to put acrylics on first, and then I'll go back over things with oils, because they're really good to feather and they're kind of transparent. But before I get into the oils, I'm gonna put this color down. I'll look it over, and then I'll probably blend in some different colors into the shadows to make darker shadows, and then the highlights I'll use acrylics to dry brush some highlights. But overall, I'm gonna probably put quite a few coats of paint on here, thin coats, transparent coats, a lot of them, some dry brush that is very subtle. Because what you don't want it to be is you don't want it to look like paint. You want it to look like a real creature with real skin. And so you're going to achieve that best by not just painting it like you'd paint a car, like a cherry or a fire engine red, or something like that. Animals have a lot of subtle variances in their skin tones usually. So to get this to look more three-dimensional also, you pick colors that are lighter and to some degree the opposite of each other. For instance, I might do the shadows with a purple and do the highlights with a little bit of yellow mixed in with that gray. I may do the other way you could do is reds and greens. You can do blues and oranges. They're not going to be super obvious, usually, unless you want like a poster art look. But that's kind of how I approach it. And when you're done, if you do it right, it should still look gray. when you look at it in general, but when you look up close, it's just got a little bit more shape and more depth to it, I guess. More seems more three-dimensional. Even though you're painting something that's three-dimensional, you can make it look pretty flat by painting it with just a solid gray and then a lighter gray dry brushing. But paint inside the places like under the arms and different cracks and crevices, in the segments of the tail, a little bit darker, and anything that would be the cracks around the knees. And then you might even want to paint in the dust and dirt that would be on his knees and tail, because he comes out of the sand in the opening scene. But think about that kind of stuff. You can also paint light. How the light's going to hit. What is the? Is it going to be like lightning around him, or is it fire? You can paint those reflections on its skin, because when you look at the movie, depending on what's going on, that affects the color of Godzilla quite a bit. You don't usually see Godzilla looking green, except in Godzilla 2000. He's actually got a green suit there. Most of the time, he's a dark to medium gray. But anyway, that's some of the color theory I just wanted to share with you. So as I'm painting this on, I'll go back over it, and I'll probably, on the ends of the fins, put in a little bit of a lighter color so I can blend it into sort of a bone, almost white. So that's what I got so far, and next time you see it, it should look a little bit more painted and demonstrate some of the other techniques on future video. Okay, thanks. Thanks for watching. Bye.